avoid these for healthy hair. This is really, really important for you to know, because in life also you experience that you do so many good things and nobody remembers, and you do something wrong and people remember it for weeks and months and years. Sometimes the same thing happens to the body, that of course we're all proactive, we're all ambitious and we're doing a lot of right things, but a few things we may be doing wrong knowingly or unknowingly can be harming us. So whatever I share in the next 10 minutes, I want you to just understand that these things are not good for you. They are harming you in ways small or big. But I also want you to remember that you got to be gentle on yourself. You can indulge in what you like to a moderate extent, because it is absolutely not possible or practical to be robotic and have extreme non-negotiables in areas of food. So just know that the awareness that these things are harming you and really harming you, and how you can limit them whenever you can, is going to improve your health to a big deal. So I just want to tell you that be gentle on yourself, because many times I have seen that after I have educated people, they go on an extreme avoidance kind of a regime and then they give up because then it is too frustrating. So I want you to practice whatever is possible, but consistently. What you do long term is what is going to give you the incredible results that you desire and you absolutely deserve. So we talk about sugar. You've heard this before and you're hearing this again, but this time I know that it will come across to you much more powerfully and much more, you'll have greater connect to this, because we are in this together. So this is a journey we are taking together. So now you will connect to this more and give up on sugar more than ever, because sugar really causes spikes in energy level and spikes in insulin. Remember, we said this in the last chapter. So we don't want to have those spikes. Those are harmful to you. So reduce sugar as much as possible. Sugar and sugary food to be avoided. Processed food, again, it does the same thing. So food which we store, what we call as sukha nashta, those chips and the farsan and other things that we store and keep munching on, the lesser you have of it, the better it is for your health. And then empty calories. There is a video on empty calories. Any of these terms you kind of understand, but you have questions asking, what exactly is it? Can you tell me? Yes, I will tell you. You just need to ask me on the Facebook group. So what are these empty calories? Empty calories are what give you energy but do not give you nutrition. Remember, we said think nutrition, not calories. So this is giving you calories, not giving you nutrition. I want less calories and more nutrition. That is my ideal thing to have. So these are three things you will avoid. Another thing you will avoid is starving or eating too few calories. Calories is not such a bad thing. It's a good thing. It gives you energy. You need the energy. So you have to eat the right amount of calories. Absolutely starving, not eating anything, completely giving up on carbohydrates and eating less than your body needs will make your metabolism very, very slow. And when your metabolism gets very slow, then you come across a different set of problems, which we will not be discussing right now. But just for you to know that eating more is not good, but eating less is also not good. So then you need to eat such that you feel, you know, you need to connect more to your body. You need to feel well. You need to feel high energy, enthusiasm, have lesser mood swings. So you will know once you start at the end of the day or the beginning of the day asking yourself that my daily regime, how does it make me feel? So hit the right balance. Do not compromise to an extent that you're eating too less. That doesn't help either. Then we come to completely avoiding food from one group. So fat diets are quite common, where I see that people say, no, maine bilkul ye band kar diya hai, main sirf juice peeti hoon, ya maine bilkul chapati khana band kar diya hai, ya rice totally band kar diya hai, carbs totally band kar diya hai, bilkul main ek drop tel bhi nahi leti hoon, maine ye bina tel ka banaya hai, main pura khana bina tel ka hi banati hoon, main oily bilkul hi nahi khati hoon. So there is this extreme thing, like we spoke about the groups of food. I'm sure you remember the carbohydrates, the proteins, the fat and the fiber. Each of these groups have a role to play in the body. None of these groups are ups absolutely good or absolutely bad. Just because we said protein is a better food, that doesn't mean ki you can eat only protein, because protein has a particular role to play in the body, which is an important role, but it doesn't do everything in the body. For everything in the body, you need all these four foods. So please do not completely avoid fruit from any one group. Short term, you may see weight loss, but you will not see better hair by doing this. And then eating foods that don't feel right, which means that listen to your body. Your body knows what is right for it. Your body will give you those signs. Most of the times we do not listen to those signs. I did also say somewhere that I do not do a lot of blood tests, because by asking the right questions, by spending some time understanding what is happening to the body, you will know what it likes and it doesn't like. So if you eat something and you feel too bloated, you eat something and you feel too lethargic, then somehow that food is not right for you. And if the food is not right for you, it is messing up with your digestion. And if your digestive system is not happy, your absorption is messed up with, and then you're eating right but you do not have a good digestion and a good absorption, then it is of no great use. Some people have gluten allergies, some people don't like a particular kind of food. So if you do not like a particular kind of food emotionally, or if your body doesn't feel happy with a particular kind of food, do not eat it. There are substitutes to all kind of food. That is why I said that we're going to make this journey fun and easy. We're not going to be like, you have to do this, you must do this, there is no option but to do this. We are going to find out if this feels right for us, this feels light to us, and if it does, we're going to embrace it. If it doesn't feel light and right to us, we're going to look for other options, and other options are available. So you can get whatever you want. Of course, you can't get everything, because you need to get that balance that this I will not do, but instead of this, this I'm willing to do. So it is those options that we are going to find out in the Healthy Hair Masterclass. What is the right fitment for you? What you can do easily so that you can have healthy hair for life. I hope that this is important. I think this is a very, very, very important part of nutrition, because many times I say that people are walking and people are gymming, but then they may lose like 1,000 calories in gymming, but then after a gym, if they have a fruit juice, and that also a fruit juice from a carton, then they may be putting back all the calories that they lost just in that 5 minutes of drinking that large bowl of fruit juice, or having some kind of cookies, or sometimes those little things can reverse all the good things we have done. So leaving you with a message which is quite important, you might want to write it down and apply it even to the other areas of your life, because sometimes what we stop doing is more important than what we do. What we do, of course, is important, but what we stop doing, absolutely very, very important. So what are you going to stop doing? Will you tell me on the Facebook group?